Welcome and welcome back to the FIFA 20 Inter Milan career mode. My name is Dwayne Starr and this is episode number 7. Before we continue this episode, don't forget to leave a thumbs up. I would appreciate that very much. If you like this series but haven't subscribed, subscribe now to the channel and don't forget to turn on that notification bell. Now let's go straight to the press conference. The first and only question of this episode is from the Sisu 1988. First of all, thank you for your compliment. If you are having a hard time getting Eriksen to work, try switching the formation to a 3-4-1-2 formation with Eriksen behind the strikers. I would definitely try this formation in this episode, so thank you for your comment. Now let's go to the first game of this episode. But before we do that, let's have a quick look at the schedule of today. This is the schedule of today. We are in the month of December. We got Spal, Roma, Slavia Praag, Fiorentina and Genoa. We will play the games against AS Roma, Slavia Praag and Fiorentina. And of course, we will simulate the games against Spal and Genoa. You have decided and the player of the last episode was of course Romelu Lukaku. Like always in the last episode, Romelu Lukaku was on fire. And at the moment, there's nobody even close to his performance. So this is the squad at the moment. Martinez and Barella are injured. But Martinez will return very soon. Barella will be out for 2 months, right? Yeah. Now let's have a quick look at the progression of some of our players. Esposito got a +4. He's now 71 overall. Martinez is now 85 overall. +2, De Vrij +1, Skriniar, Bastoni, Eriksen, Gagliardini, Barella, Brozovic, Sensi. So most of the players are doing pretty good. I expect Lukaku to reach an 87 overall pretty soon because his stats are going up also. Ball control +2 already, nice. Heading accuracy, stamina, acceleration. Okay, cool. And of course, some of our players are getting worse. Sanchez, Young, and Ambrosio. All -1. I didn't expect Sanchez to go down this soon though. Only 30 years old. And look at this. Handanovic, his stats are going down also. Agility, -1. Diving, -1. And kicking, -4. Martinez is back from his injury. But he is not fit enough. And we gotta replace Barella also. Gagliardini. And for Martinez, Esposito, 72 overall. Nice. Barella gotta be replaced by Valero. And I think we are good to go. No, wait a minute. You know what? Let's bring... I don't know, man. I think Sanchez must play instead of Esposito, though. The first game of this episode is against Pau. Let's go. The first game of this episode against Pau. 1-0 Eriksen with the game winner. It is time to play the first game of this episode and it is going to be against AS Roma. AS Roma is in 5th place with 31 points. We are in 6th place with 27 points. We gotta win this game to close the gap. Like I said, the goal is to finish in the top 3 of the Serie A. The goal scorer for AS Roma is Zego with 10 goals, Pellegrini with 6 goals and Mkhitaryan with 4 goals. The man of the assist is Veretout with 3 assists, but also Pellegrini got 3 assists. And then we got Mkhitaryan, Perotti and Sanolio all with 2 assists. Zego got the highest rating with a 7.4. Then we got Diawara with 7.3. And then we got Mkhitaryan with 7.2. Also Perotti, by the way, with 7.2. It is time to begin.
Ci siamo. Possiamo dare inizio alla conferenza stampa. Purtroppo il tempo a nostra disposizione è finito. Un grazie a tutti i partecipanti.
So this is going to be the lineup for the game against AS Roma. Handanovic on goal, Skriniar, De Vrij and Godin as the center backs, Brozovic as the defensive midfielder, Eriksen and Sensi as the center mids, Tagliafico on the left wing, Pereira on the right wing and Martinez and Lukaku at the striker position. This game is very importante. Welcome to the game against AS Roma. Campaign to remember. Zego. What is going on? He is on fire? Yes, he is. Okay. That is going to be a problem, of course, for Inter Milan. This is the lineup for AS Roma. Lopez on goal. Kolarov is de left-back. Fazio en Smalling is de center-backs. Zappacosta is de right-back. Cristante, Diawara en Pellegrini on de midfield. Spinazzola on de left-wing. Mkhitaryan on de right-wing. En Zeko is de striker. The first game of this episode is against AS Roma. One of the biggest games in the Serie A. I forgot. I should have changed the formation. But I can still do it though. Hold up. Eriksen behind the strikers. Let's try. Eriksen. Sensi. A little bit behind. Then of course Brozovic instead of Eriksen. Because Eriksen must be behind the strikers. Let's try. Eriksen to Tagliafico. Tagliafico with the... And there is going to be a goal. No, it's not. Paul Lopez with a beautiful save. But there should have been a goal. Inter Milan with the corner. Can we create the opportunity? Let's go. Skriniar against... Yo, what? What? Skriniar with a miss. Yo, this is the first time. This is the first time. I was this dangerous with the corner. Interception from Spinazzola. Somebody needs to get him. Is he that fast? Yes, he is. He's pretty fast. And that's the save from Handanovic. Kolarov. Spinazzola. Again. Spinazzola again. And again the save from Handanovic. And that's going to be a yellow card. 100%. Diawara with the yellow card. Of course. No question about it. From behind. He didn't even touch the ball. Look at this. And he is complaining? Come on, bruh. Pereira. Lukaku with his right foot. Oh, my. So unlucky. Skriniar. Tagliafico with a lot of space, but the referee decides to blow the whistle. Still 0-0. These are the stats for the first half. We had 64% possession, 3 shots, 1 on target, 33% shot accuracy. That is not good enough. This is going to be it. This is going to be it. Lautaro, where's your speed, bro? Lautaro with a... Yo, what a shot. And what a save from Lopez. Pereira. Pereira. This is going to be a goal from Brozovic! Pereira with the assist. Pereira with another assist. I think he's leading. He's leading the assist for Inter Milan. 1-0 up against AS Roma. Again, the crossing from Pereira. To Brozovic, what a beautiful crossing. And what a goal. What a goal from Brozovic. We are up 1-0 against AS Roma. We need to make some changes though. Maybe not, but hold up. Let's bring in Esposito for Martinez because Martinez is having a bad game. I mean, like, Martinez should perform way better. He's 85 overall, but he is invisible in this game. And who else do we want to see? Maybe. I think this is good enough. Maybe Biraghi for Tagliafico. Let's do that. Because Tagliafico, his stamina is not good enough anymore. Sensi for Gagliardini. Let's go. Zego. Zego lost the ball to Stefan. What the? That is not a foul, ref. Interception. Gagliardini. Gagliardini! And the save from Lopez again. This is going to be a counter. Oh, never mind. We won the game 1-0 against AS Roma. This is a big result for us. We closed the gap to 1 point with AS Roma. I am so proud of my players, man. We won the game 1-0 against AS Roma. Big result. The player of the game is Brozovic, and I do agree. These are the stats of the game. 56% possession for us, 8 shots, 6 on target, 75% shot accuracy. That is much better. AS Roma only created one opportunity. The defense from Inter Milan killed it today. We have got a message from Fassino. Hold up. He wants to play more. I think the next game is going to be a perfect opportunity because we are already going through to the next round of the Champions League. The second game of this episode is going to be against Slavia Prague. This is the second unit. Padelli on goal, Ranocchia, Bastoni and Ambrosio is the center back. Vecino is the defensive midfielder. Sensi and Gagliardini is the center mid. Biragi on the left wing, Moses on the right wing and Esposito and Giunto at the striker position. Hold up. The bench. Martinez, Aguma, Valero, Godin, Jong, Asamoah and Skriniar. 4 minutes ultimate, like I said, we already qualified for the next round. This is a perfect moment for my starting 11 to get some well-deserved rest. This is the starting 11 for Slavia Prague. This is the formation they are playing in, a 4-5-1 formation again. Let's go. Esposito is now a 72 overall, man. He's getting better. He's getting better and better. There goes Esposito, by the way. That is not offside. Please, please, please. It is not. That's going to be the goal. Oh my, oh my. So unlucky. So unlucky. Ambrosio. Vecino with the pass. What a beautiful attack again. Esposito. Early shot though. Maybe too soon. I don't know. And Biragi still got the ball. Esposito again. Yo, Esposito. What is going on, bro? Victor Moses. Esposito. Esposito again. Yo, it's a goal. Esposito. Esposito is back. Esposito is doing it again. That pass came from Sensi, I believe. Look at that strike from Esposito, though. Future legend. Future legend, for sure. And that is going to be the end of the first half. We are leading the game 1-0. What a surprise, though. With the second unit against Slavia Prague. These are the stats for the first half. 47% possession, 5 shots. 5 shots on target? What? Shot accuracy 100%. Yo, what is going on? The second half just started. Esposito. Esposito is going all the way. Esposito! Wow, what a move from Esposito, the young striker from Inter Milan. That shot was pretty poor though, bruh. He should have finished it. Victor Moses. That's a yellow card. Disgusting tackle. Disgusting tackle. From Boreo. This is going to be trouble. Good defense. Moses. There goes Giunto. An own goal. An own goal from Kudela. Wow. 2-0. Esposito. Esposito! Esposito, I'm telling you, man. Season number 2, he is going to be, I don't know, man. Maybe he's going to be a starter. I don't know. 72 overall at the moment, but again, look how he's performing right now. 72 overall, still. And already playing like this. 3-0. Aguma. I see somebody on the right wing. Ashley Young with the goal, 4-0. What a beautiful goal though, man. Came from Manchester United. 34 years old, I believe. 33, 34, 35, something like that. The pass to Young was also pretty nice though. 4-0. Don't blow the whistle. Come on. 4-0. 4-0 victory against Slavia Prague. What a beautiful day. The player of the game is Esposito. And these are the stats of the game. 49% possession, 10 shots, 7 on target, 70% shot accuracy, and Slavia Prague with no shots at all. So the defense from Inter Milan was excellent today. So because we are going through to the next round of the Champions League, we have got 27.8 million to the bank for next season. Nice. Fassino was pretty happy that I gave him some minutes in the last game, and he did pretty well. The last game of this episode is going to be against Fiorentina, and look at this. Esposito was on fire in the Champions League, man. Yo, Esposito is coming. He's coming for Haaland, he's coming for Mbappe, he's coming for everybody. At the moment, Fiorentina is in 12th place with 16 points. The gap to Inter Milan is 14 points. Yo, we gotta win this game. The top scorer for Fiorentina is Cotrone with 5 goals and Kwame and Dalbert with 3. The man of the assist is Lirola with 4 assists, Duncan with 3, and also Cotrone. Cotrone is doing pretty good. Duncan got the best rating with a 6.3, Kwame with a 6.1. Cotrone only a 6 though. He got the most goals and he got 3 assists. That is crazy. The last game of this episode is going to be against Fiorentina. We got Handanovic on goal, Skriniar, De Vrij and Godin as the center back, Brozovic as the defensive midfielder, Eriksen and Sensi as the center mids, Tagliafico on the left wing, Pereira on the right wing, and Sanchez and Lukaku at the striker position. This is the starting 11 for Fiorentina. They got Milenkovic, Cáceres and Pesela as center backs, Pulgar, Duncan and Binacio on midfield, Dalbert on the left wing, Lirola on the right wing, and Cotrone and Kouame at the striker position. Christian Eriksen. What a bad pass from Christian Eriksen. Pulgar to Cotrone to Kouame. Again Pulgar. Wow. We are in trouble. Fiorentina on the fast break. And a shot from Duncan. What? The first try for Fiorentina already. Very dangerous. Lucky for us, no goal. Brozovic. Sensi. And that is going to be a goal from Brozovic. Again, Brozovic. He's going to be the player of the episode. What a run from Brozovic and what a pass. Sanchez is playing instead of Martinez. I made a mistake, bruh. Come on, you are way stronger. Lukaku with the interception. Sanchez! Alexis Sanchez! What the? Sanchez! I made a big mistake by playing him instead of Martinez. That is my mistake though, but what? Alexis Sanchez with an assist and a goal. Sanchez is proving me wrong though. He is proving me wrong. Clinical finish from Alexis Sanchez, 2-0. Whoa, hold on. Come on, man. Fiorentina on the attack. Handanovic, come on, get up. What? Yo, Cotrone, you are getting fired by Fiorentina. This is impossible. How did you miss from this close, my man? Wow. Sensi. Lukaku! The save from Dragoski. And that is the end. And the end of the first half also, because there's no more time. I hope. Maybe not. Hold on, ref. Come on, ref! Come on! 2-0. These are the stats of the first half. 50% possession, shots on target 4, and although we are up 2-0, they still had 3 shots. We gotta watch out. Alexis Sanchez! Alexis Sanchez! What a shot! What a beautiful shot! Christian Eriksen, 3-0. Clinical finish again. Game over, man. What else can I say? What else can I say? The passing was amazing. Christian Eriksen is playing way better with this formation. So, shout out to you. Whoever gave me that formation. Again, the goal from Christian Eriksen. Easy finish. 3-0. Cutrone. Duncan. Togar to Cutrone. And that is going to be a goal. No, it's not. And Danipis with the save. There goes Sensi. Eriksen, Lukaku. Sensi. Yo, what is going on, man? We are unstoppable. Godin. Good defense from Godin. And we won the game 3-0. Fiorentina was not ready. The final stats of the game. 52% possession. 8 shots. 6 on target. 75% shot accuracy. Fiorentina was not ready for us. And the man of the match is going to be Alexis Sanchez. So one of my colleagues is informing me that I might lose some players if I don't renew the contract. Let's see. Padelli, Valero, Young and Bernie. Bernie is 36. 63 overall. We are not going to resign him. Padelli, 34, 74 overall. Padelli, his stats are going down, so we are not going to resign him also. And also, Young and Valero, we are not going to resign. Valero is just too slow, and Young, I think we can do better. Alexis Sanchez was the player of the last game, but still, Martinez is back in the starting 11. This is going to be the last game of this episode against Genoa. Let's go. The game against Genoa. Can we win? Yes, we won the game 2-0 against Genoa. Eriksen and Martinez with the goals. Whoa. No. Brozovic is injured. We are so lucky. Only 7 days. This is the standing at the moment. Juventus is in first place with 42 points. Napoli is in second place with 40 points. Torino is in third place with 38 points. Lazio is in fourth place also with 38 points. We are in 5th place with 36 points and AS Roma is in 6th place with 34 points. And then we got Atalanta at 7, Cagliari at 8, Milan at 9 and number 10 is Genoa. So we are 2 points behind number 3 Torino. We gotta keep up. The top scorer in the Serie A is Ronaldo with 11 goals for Juventus. Number 2 is Zego with 10 goals for Roma. And number 3 is Ramsey with 10 goals for Juventus also. The top goalscorer for Inter Milan is Eriksen with 9 goals. Eriksen? Really? Lukaku got a step up. And the man of the assist in the Serie A is Luis Alberto with 7 assists for Lazio. Number 2 is Dybala with 7 assists for Juventus. And number 3 is Insigne with 6 assists for Napoli. The man of the assist for Inter Milan is Pereira with 5 assists. This is going to be the end of the episode. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to leave a thumbs up. I would appreciate that very much if you like this series. But haven't subscribed. Subscribe now to the channel. And don't forget to turn on that notification bell. I'm Outski.